Hey, Robbie Malinoski here. One of the things that we were working on today, not only just putting in laps, trying to get ready for that first race, is some of the techniques in the corners, the starts. After the start, one of the most important things for me is the corners. And that first corner is always a game of playing, kind of protect your line and making sure that the whole pack can't get inside of you. So I always try to ride a tighter line, make sure that I accelerate sooner than anybody else, and try to distance myself within the first lap. So when it comes to corners in general, there's two basic ways to go about it. You can drive in really fast and hard, slam on the brakes, slide the back end around, and drive out. And that works great in certain times. But then the other way that I like to try to go about it is seeing farther ahead and trying to carry my speed around the whole corner. So on the second style of corner, it's basically trying to look a little farther ahead than you normally would, so you can carry more speed around that corner and then in result lower your lap times. So going back to corners, dealing with flat corners, one of the things that you're going to want to do is just make sure your weight is hanging off the sled as much as you can, because at that point it just becomes a balance game, trying to find the traction to turn and not having your sled catch an edge to tip over. But moving from there into a banked corner, you drive in really sharp, or really fast, mind you, and slide the back end around. You find yourself squared up and straight for the next straightaway to launch the first jump, first obstacle. And after you make that first one, the second, the third, the fourth become a lot easier.
Well, I think at a corner like that, and I think Tim will agree, anytime you find yourself kind of rolling around the outside and hitting bumps, it ends up taking more time to get through it. So I always like to just try to point and shoot, drive in as hard as I can, slide the back end around, and then drive out. And then I'm a little bit more set up for the next obstacle. I'm not still turning up the face of a jump or a whoop or anything like that.
Yeah, I think you're saving energy too. Instead of going outside and just pounding through bumps, you just kind of go inside, cut the bump inside, and then straight line, so kind of save a little bit of energy right there too.